So multimodal biomarkers is a combination of two or more individual biomarker measures. They could be imaging, electrophysiology, cognitive, digital measures, speech measures, blood-based measures, including genomics and other measures. And they tell us about the biological characteristics of a disease.
Can we intervene? Can we identify? Can we even predict before a disease starts? And most importantly, these gives more tool in hands of the physicians and healthcare worker to do something meaningful helping the patients.
And so when I think about meaningful measures, I really do think about brain imaging, brain scans, and how, you know, interesting and cool that would have been in the first place just to see my brain, but then also how informative it could have been in sort of like a partnership conversation with my clinician to show me what my brain scans looked like, and perhaps choosing treatment that can help treat some of the things that I could see on the brain scan.
When you walk into a doctor's office and you present with a particular CNS disorder, they will be able to give you a battery of tests. It could be an imaging test, it could be a blood-based test, it could be a genetic risk test, and those tests will be able to tell your doctor which of the variety of treatments that are available to treat your particular condition would be the right for you.
I guess the future for the biomarker development is bright. Of course, not without challenges.
So for example, rigorous data methods are needed in order to diagnose particular CNS disorders.
But certainly thinking about standardizing prospectively, publishing what are best practices, what would a piece of equipment or a way of collecting data have to look like? A lot of people use resting fMRI, resting EEG, and standard protocols. We should standardize that explicitly to a certain extent.
In terms of validation, you want to link the biomarker to the context of use. You're certainly going to look at the benefits and risks of introducing that variability and what are the needs that that biomarker is intended to address.
I think that it's reasonable to expect that the amount of data necessary to qualify multimodal biomarkers will be more extensive than the amount of data necessary to qualify a unimodal biomarker. And for clinical utility, I think this is applicable to unimodal as well, is that we have to understand the risk of the multimodal biomarkers. Is it invasive? What is this false negative rate, false positive rate? The expense, availability of the tests, measurement of instrument, and the level of expertise that is needed to actually interpret the multimodal biomarker.
People need coverage for these types of biomarkers. If without coverage, even if they're FDA cleared, clinicians and patients do not have access to them, and they will not add value to the patient and clinical experience.
There is a historical history of mistrust in the science community, and that could be part of the reason as to why we do not see an overwhelming number of African Americans specifically who enroll in clinical trials. And so I think that the science community has to do a better job of rebuilding that trust, educating those populations in a proper way to get them excited and want to enroll in these studies.
A single lab will not solve this, you know, not even a single company probably. So we need to collaborate, we need to share data.
Biomarker development takes a village. We need to leverage as many resources as we can and diversify the approaches, the collaborations, the stakeholders. This reduces risk, increases return on investment, and allows more shots on goal.
I guess the really unique aspect of this workshop is the range of voices that we have put together. We need to bring together scientists, patient community, academia, industry, policymakers, regulators, everyone in one room. I guess the timing for this workshop is very relevant, mainly for the reason that there is definitely a lot more focus on the unmet needs in mental health, especially post-pandemic. Clearly, the technology is driving. We do understand now how we can use machine learning to make sure create the right algorithm, which takes care of not just the sometimes challenges with not enough having adequate diversity of the data, but you can overcome that. But most importantly, you can think about how do you create tools which are scalable and can be used in clinic. I think that's why this is a great time for this workshop, because it should hopefully create the next steps and most importantly, bring the right people together who would drive these next steps.